If you have a new Samsung Galaxy Watch, or have had one for some time now and are looking to make sure you're getting the most out of your smartwatch, in this video, we'll look at 7 settings you can change to add features and overall improve your experience with your Galaxy Watch. And if you're new here, consider subscribing to the channel for more smartwatch and tech content like this. First is continuous heart rate monitoring. By default, your Galaxy Watch only measures your heart rate about once every 10 minutes when you're resting, and I recommend switching to the continuous heart rate measuring mode. There are a few added benefits when the continuous measuring mode is enabled. First, your watch will now be able to calculate your resting heart rate, as well as provide you with your resting heart rate trends. Second, if you used the heart rate complication on your watch face, the reading will now be updated regularly, letting you glance at the watch face at any time and get your current heart rate reading. Third, you'll be able to see from the Samsung Health app your heart rate range by 3-minute intervals, providing you a more detailed view of your heart rate throughout the day. To enable this feature, open the Samsung Health app on your Galaxy Watch. Select Heart Rate. Scroll all the way to the bottom and select Settings. Make sure Measure Continuously is selected. You should see a filled-in blue circle next to this option. Next is App Notification Settings. I recommend, especially if this is a brand new watch, to review which of your phone app's notifications are forwarded to your Galaxy Watch, to make sure you aren't missing notifications from important apps, and also to turn off forwarding of less important app notifications. You can manage which of your phone app notifications get forwarded to your Galaxy Watch from the Galaxy Wearable app on your Android phone. Open the Galaxy Wearable app, select Watch Settings, then Notifications, and then App Notifications. Here, you'll see all your phone and watch apps. You can toggle off or on notifications by using the toggle to the right of the app's name. So, if you'd like to get text message notifications forwarded to your watch, for example, make sure your messaging apps like Messages, WhatsApp, and other messaging apps you use have watch notifications enabled. Other apps I check to make sure notifications are being sent to my watch are calendar and to-do list apps. Third is display settings. There are several display-related settings worth looking through to make sure you're getting the best experience with your Galaxy Watch. First, if you don't need always-on display mode, I recommend turning off always-on display mode, as you'll get much better battery life. With this mode off and light to moderate use, I get around a day to a day and a half of battery life with my Galaxy Watch 6. You can enable or disable Always On Display by swiping down from the very top to open Quick Settings, and tap the icon that looks like a watch. Blue means the mode is on, gray means the mode is off. If you turn off Always On Display mode, I do recommend making sure Raise to Wake is on, so you can wake the display by turning your wrist. You can enable Raise to Wake from Settings, Display, then make sure Raise Wrist to Wake is enabled. Next, I recommend you review the font size options to see if you'd prefer a larger or smaller font size. Now, though the font size settings do not change the size of the text on the watch face, it does change the font size in menus, apps, and the text of notifications. To change the font size, go to the Settings app, select Display, and scroll down and select Font Size. From here, you can use the plus and minus buttons to increase or decrease the font size. One other way you can customize your Galaxy Watch is by installing new watch faces. And if you're looking for new watch faces for your Galaxy Watch, consider checking out my watch faces for Wear OS smartwatches. Find a link in the video description. Fourth is setting up a sleep mode schedule. Sleep mode is a mode available on your Galaxy Watch where, when enabled, notifications are muted and the screen stays off. This mode is designed to help ensure your smartwatch does not disrupt your sleep. I recommend setting up this mode to turn on and off automatically. In summary, you can set up the schedule by going to the Settings app on your watch, go to Modes, select Sleep Mode, and set up the schedule there. I've made an in-depth video on how to set up this mode. You can find it linked above or in the video description. Fifth is sounds and vibrations. Now, it's important to note, your Galaxy Watch does have a speaker, and if set to the standard mode, will play a notification sound when you get a notification or alert. Now, I prefer setting my watch to vibrate, so notifications and other alerts will only vibrate the watch, and ensure my watch won't be a disruption to those around me. You can change this setting by going to the Settings app, go to Sounds and Vibration, and select Vibrate. Sixth is customize buttons. A cool feature of the Galaxy Watch is that you can customize the functionality of what the physical buttons do. From the Settings app, go to Advanced Features, then Customize Buttons. Double press of the Home button has more options, letting you use this action to open any app you choose. For example, I've set up for mine to open the Google Wallet app. The press and hold of the Home button lets you select between opening a voice assistant or the power menu. You can also set if the back button goes to the previous screen or opens the recent apps menu. Seventh is disconnection alerts. Your Galaxy Watch can alert you when your watch has lost connection with your phone, perhaps alerting you if you've left your phone behind. When this happens, your watch will vibrate, and you'll see this phone disconnected icon at the top. You can enable this from the Settings app. Select Advanced Features, and select Disconnection Alerts. Here, you can select either to play a sound and vibration only, or also include a full screen alert with the sound and vibration. Be sure to like this video if you've found it helpful. And if you're looking to further add features to your Galaxy Watch, check out this video on how to set up the Google Assistant on your watch. Thanks for watching. Until next time.